Hey guys, today I'm going to show you the extraordinary alignment of Angkor Wat Temple Complex in Cambodia. This is the largest Hindu temple in the world. And as I reached the very center of the temple, I found a square carved on the floor. And there's something very strange about this square. What is this and why is it carved on the floor of the main tower of Angkor Wat? When I put my phone in the middle and opened my compass, suddenly I realized its meaning. It's perfectly aligned to the four directions. It is so precise. Look, my phone is placed exactly aligned with the lines carved on the floor. The compass shows the exact 90-degree alignment with not even a fraction of a difference in angles. See this line? It's perfectly facing north. And see that's the north entrance. This line is perfectly facing south. That's the south entrance. And this east, that's the main east entrance. Perfect, the degree is perfect. And that's the west entrance. Four entrances precisely matching the four points of the direction. If you stand on this square and look around you, you feel weird because you realize that everything around you is perfectly built with alignment to the cardinal direction points with no human errors at all. This ancient Hindu temple is said to be built at least 900 years ago. So, how did the ancient builders achieve this level of accuracy? And look at the top. On the ceiling, there are four lines coming at 90-degree angles. Each line is coming from the exact direction point and meeting at the center. If you observe carefully, you will also see more direction lines than just east, west, north, and south. Yes, you can also see northeast, northwest, southeast, and southwest as well. All the eight lines meet precisely on the ceiling, exactly on top of the square, on the floor. This kind of system is just insane. As above, so below, right? But this is mind-boggling. You know why? This temple could be thousands of years old, but even by conservative mainstream archaeological accounts, it was built around 1120 AD. That is 900 years ago. Just to give you some perspective, there were no compasses in Europe at that time at all. The very first compass, which was capable of showing just four directions, appeared in Europe only 100 years after this temple was built, around 1200 AD. And this temple, which was supposed to be built with primitive tools, has a perfect alignment without even a fraction of an error margin. This is like modern-day GPS precision level. To argue that the ancient builders looked at the stars, the sun, and the moon and created this kind of an alignment is not a valid argument at all. You cannot even achieve this level of precision with a primitive natural compass made of lodestone. You need advanced technology to do this. Is it possible that Angkor Wat was built with advanced ancient technology? Now, let's take a step back and think for a minute. Is it really that hard to build with this level of accuracy? After all, this is the main structure. This is at the very center of Angkor Wat Temple Complex. This is the ultimate stop, which houses the main chamber. The ancient engineers would have paid all the attention to the angles and directions of the structure, because this is literally the center of attraction, right? let's face it, this compass only proves that this main structure is aligned perfectly. It does not mean that everything in this entire temple complex is aligned perfectly. In order to find out if the entire temple complex is aligned perfectly, I needed to examine more structures in the complex. So I started to climb down from the main tower because now I was in the center of the temple complex, but I wanted to go to the edge of the complex and find a structure which is at the borders, at the periphery of the complex. And this was a very, very big temple, guys. It's about 400 acres. It is huge. So I walked out from this central area, got out of the sacred temples area, and you see this small structure far away from the temple towers. This is where I was walking now. From the ground view, you can see how far I have come. I was inside the main tower there. That's where we found that magic square with perfect alignment. This structure is not even considered a part of the temple, even though it is located inside the complex. Archaeologists call this the library because they believe it once housed plenty of ancient texts. As soon as I entered this structure, I saw a square right in the middle of the floor, strangely reminding me of the one I saw before. This time, I put the phone right on top of the line near the square, so you can see it more accurately if it matches the direction points. And yes, this is incredible because this line is perfectly aligned to the east. You can see the 90 degrees. You can see the line on the floor aligned with modern-day GPS level of precision. And if you look in the exact same line, through that doorway. The camera cannot see it because it's too bright, but if you visit this place and see it with your naked eye, you can see the Angkor Wat towers through the doorway. This is just mind-boggling level of accuracy in engineering. So this square, again, is just a perfect pointer of four directions, north, south, east, and west, and look at how every entrance is perfectly matching the direction point. Now, I just looked up above, and again, the exact same feature where four lines meet at the center. I mean, how could they do this 900 years ago? Now, you have just seen something truly extraordinary, okay? Because this means that the entire temple complex was built with GPS level of precision. I just showed you two samples, one in the middle of the temple and another one from the edge of the complex. Both of them are acres apart, and yet they're aligned with the precision of zero error margin. Just ask a modern day engineer if he can even build a small house with this level of precision. The answer will be no, because you cannot maintain this level of accuracy even if you build a house with just 10 rooms. So how did the so-called primitive ancient people, who supposedly used nothing more than chisels and hammers, build a temple which stretches for 400 acres where every structure is precisely aligned with the direction points? If you look at the aerial view of Angkor Wat, the higher you go, the less it starts to look like a temple. It starts to look like a giant computer chip or electronic chip from the top view. I wonder how it would look from space, because it just looks so stunningly awesome, and we don't know how the ancient builders accomplished this kind of magnitude with this level of precision. But the other question is, why? Why was such a precision necessary? When we build a house today, we don't build it with this kind of precision because we don't need this level of precision. However, when we build advanced technical devices, for example, we try to make them as precise as possible with zero tolerance. was this massive complex built merely for worshiping and rituals? Or was it built for some other advanced purpose that we are not able to understand today? I think it is safe to say that we don't understand much about ancient technology which existed here. We know it is very advanced, but we don't know who did it, how they did it, and why they did it. We pretty much do not understand anything about this. It's weird because the more you learn about this, there is only one thing you understand, that you don't understand anything at all. So what do you think? Did ancient builders have advanced compasses and devices just like what we have today? How else is this level of precision possible? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I am Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and also click on the bell button to get all the updates. Please give this video a thumbs up and do share it with your friends. I will talk to you soon. Bye.